By noon, the dragon filled the house. Its head hung out the front door. Its tail hung out the back door. And there wasn't a room in the house that didn't have some part of the dragon in it. I bet that there's a house like that on... Some of you live, you know, where there's a lot of houses. Some of you live in apartments. Doesn't really matter. But I bet you if you live in a house, on a block of houses, there's at least one house on that street where the tail of the dragon has started to come out of the house. And you know what that's like, eh? Because it's the house that you don't really want to look at when you walk by. You know, and maybe, I don't know, that needs a new roof and like the door is a little bit crooked and the lawn isn't cut and, you know, there's some rusty things lying around there. And like it's just not taken care of. And you know, and maybe you know from the gossip in the neighborhood too, that there's something going on in that house that is just not good. And it's got to the point where it's so not good that it's starting to spread itself out beyond the domestic confines of the house. So, you know, you run into people like that now and then too. You'll notice this. So, you know, sometimes, I don't know if this has happened to any of you, but it might have. It's happened to you in some ways. You know that there are those people who can't not tell you everything about what's going on in their life, even if you've hardly even met them. If you see someone who's really in trouble, you know, you'll sit on the bus and somebody who's clearly on the road to being thoroughly deranged will sit down beside you and they'll start telling you about the problems of their life. It's like you know that the dragon that they're dealing with is so big that they can't even contain it. They're so desperate to have it dealt with that they can't not talk about it. You know, and there's lots of people like that. They're the ones, what is that stupid little phrase? TMI, is that right? Too much information? It's like, yeah, well, why does that happen? It's because people are dealing with anomalies and unexpected occurrences and tragedies and they cannot articulate a solution. And most people think by talking, which is also part of the reason that therapy works. It's right, well, do you think? I doubt it. You might, but very few people think. You know, and so if you want to solve a problem, you want to talk it over with a friend. And so, you know, you might just think that you're talking about the problem. Sort of, you know what the problem is, but you're talking about it. So you don't. When you talk about it, you articulate the problem space. You start to generate potential hypotheses about solutions. But more than that, if you're talking to someone, you can watch them just like the little kid with the mouse would watch the mother. It's like, well, here's what I think the problem is. And if you go, you know, you're listening and you go like that, you roll your eyes, you know, it's a hint to the person that maybe that's not the most appropriate way to formulate the problem. Now, maybe you don't roll your eyes, but, you know, you don't encourage them. Or maybe they tell you what the problem is and you're really actively engaged and you're nodding. Well, then they know that maybe they formulate it the way someone half sane and tolerable would formulate it. And then they can walk through the solution. So, when you sit down beside someone and they have to tell you everything, one of the things that you know is that they don't have anyone to listen to them. And part of what happens in therapy, and a huge part of it, is that you just listen. I have one client, that's all I ever do with her. She comes in once every 2 weeks, and I just sit there and listen to her for an hour. And now I can maybe have a bit of a discussion with her for the last 10 minutes. But if I try to say anything for the first 50 minutes, she just looks kind of irritated, and, you know, it's like I've interrupted the flow of the interaction. And she's alone. She doesn't have anybody to talk to. So, you know, she wants to listen to herself think. And she can't do that by herself. She has to have someone to do it with. And so, you know, people think by talking. And some people have no one to talk to. And so their problems start to spill out. And, you know, by that time you can't even help them usually. Because if you listen for 3 years, it wouldn't be enough listening. You just listen forever and you never get to the bottom of it.